Obviously, we're going to face a great opponent in Texas this week on the road. It's going to be a very good challenge for our football team, but we're going to be up for it. A little bit about Texas. They're plus two, and we're plus two. The offense is led by Sam Ellinger, quarterback. He's a very, very good football player. He's a complete football player, and he does a lot of things with his feet. He does a great job with his arm. He makes some great decisions. They have an excellent scheme. They're very similar to us on offense, and he knows where to go with the football. Keontae Ingram's a big back. He's physical, and he's explosive. Kyler Joseph may be the biggest and one of the best receivers we see all year. We're going to have a plan for them. They're very strong up front, have a very good scheme. On defense, they're 3-3-5. They're returning four starters. Their linebackers are very, very good, and so is Caden Stearns, one of the best safeties we're going to see. Joseph Asai's number 46, is an excellent linebacker. Those guys can run and hit. They blitz a whole bunch, a zone blitz football team. They're very good at blitzing. On special teams, they have a lot of great athletes. Jake Smith's an outstanding returner. We have to know where he's at all the time. This is a very well-coached, good football team. Going into Austin, Texas is going to be we have to practice the noise this week. It's going to be a loud stadium. We're playing on the turf. We're going to get there early, get ready to go. It'll be a tremendous challenge for our football team.
The offense was so good on Saturday night. Are you curious to see what it can do against the top 10 opponent?
Yeah.
Number one. And number two, of course, Tom Herman's being asked about LSU this week.
Right.
Does that make the game any more different for you, or do you really not care about all of that?
I said the second one first. Don't care. I mean, I'm happy to be the coach at LSU, and this is about our football players against their football players, so none of that means anything. I am interested in seeing how we protect our quarterback against all these blitzes. I do believe that we have the skill and the knowledge to get people open and to catch the football and make yards after catch. But we do have to protect the quarterback first, and this is going to be a challenge for us.
And it's going to be super hot this week in Austin, and they have a turf field. Are you going to do anything different this week to try to get your team ready for Saturday?
Yeah, we've been practicing in the heat, and we're going out there as many times as we can. Today we're going to practice on the grass. Tomorrow we may practice on the turf out in the heat again. Seems like it'd be a pretty nice day out there. But I think I've talked to Louisiana Tech. I talked to them some about the conditions at the stadium, some of the condition on the turf field. I think we're going to be fine.
Do you have a comp for Sam Ellinger maybe that you prepared against during your time at LSU or before?
Can you say it again?
Do you have a comp? Does he remind you of anybody, Ellinger, that you've had to prepare for?
You know, he reminds me a little bit of Tebow. And I was at another school and we had to play Tebow. And I'm not saying he's as good as Tebow. I'm not saying he's not. But he reminds me of that type of player, but he's a better thrower.
With Colin Johnson, I guess, how do you go about defending him? Do you kind of assign one guy to him, or do you guys just go side of the field with corners?
That stuff sounds good until they start giving it to the running back and they start making a lot of plays, you know. So we're going to have a sound defensive scheme. The one thing I like about Coach Aranda and our defensive staff, we may have gone into last week's game with about 15 different defenses. We used one. So our guys play. And, you know, we're going to go in there and play our base defense. Now, if we need to make adjustments as the game goes on, Coach Aranda always has some answers. So I'm sure there'll be something like that if we need it. But if we can play our base defense and play the things that we play well, that's what we're always going to do that.
Coach, over to your right up here. Going back to the offense and playing a defense like this, what does need to change? I mean, you guys played really well, obviously, but what does need to change when you face a defense as aggressive as this?
What does need to change when we face a defense?
Yeah, what different looks do you expect to give your offense playing a defense like this?
Yeah, well, first of all, offense is going to get a lot of blitzes this week. And is that what you asked me?
Yes.
Yeah, a lot of pressure. Georgia Southern played the same defense we practice every day, and there was not much of a change, so we were used to it. Obviously, there's going to be bigger, better athletes, especially in the linebacker position, the safety position. These guys are phenomenal athletes. I think it's the strength of their team. So they're going to try to probably blitz us most every down, and we have to pick it up.
And you talked about players knowing the magnitude of this game. When you're trying to take that next step and get back to that elite level, how important is it to win a game like this?
You know, it's very important, but there'll be a lot of games down the road that are just as important or more important. So we got to better learn how to handle this. You want to be on the big stage at LSU. We are on the big stage, but you know what? It's not going to change our preparation. Today's competition Tuesday. We're going to keep a level head. We're going to go out there and do the best we can today, the same thing the next day. I'm sure when we get on that plane, we're going to be fired up, ready to go. I'm sure they're going to be fired up, ready to go. Team that takes care of the ball, the team that's most physical, is going to win the football game.
We're so glad you're watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports and analysis, download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, make sure you subscribe to ESPN Plus. We'll see you there.